The 1980s were both horrible and amazing at the same time. If you lived through them, you know what I mean. Everything was ugly and neon. Color combinations were the worst. Music was weird and over-digitized. Commercialism consumed everyone. It was the best of times, it was the worst of times. For Delaney, it was the worst of times.
Thanks for asking.
I'm glad, honey, but we're talking about me right now. Attention, here.
Got it.
Okay, so do we want the good news or the great news? Alrighty, Hyper Diapers, I'll tell you. The good news is, I made matching sweaters at Susan's house today! Okay, I know, Delaney. I know this is exciting, but please, stay calm. Okay, why are you not excited?
I'm excited.
Oh, I think they're great, Mom. I really do.
Thank you for giving me plans for tomorrow. I'll make sweaters for baby bear number 2 and baby bear number 3.
All right, well, I'm assuming it'll only get worse from here, so let's hear the great news.
When I was at Sue's, she told me she was the leader for the Parental Advisory for Prom Committee.
The Parental Advisory for Prom Committee.
Yes, Delaney, the PAPC. Please keep up. Anyways, she told me it was a volunteer position and that I should have gotten a letter about it a while ago. I'm absolutely infuriated with you for not giving me that, but more on that later. And she asked me, the Deborah Ann Lawrence, or Debbie for short, to be the assistant for the prom.
No!
No? Why no? Are you not going to prom?
Oh, no. I'm going to prom. You're not.
Honey, I am one unfortunate accident away from being the head of prom. I have to chaperone, so why wouldn't I go?
Because if you go...
Because I'll show you up? Is that why? Honey, don't feel self-conscious. Not everyone can have my motherly curves. I'm telling you, some jazzercise and speed walking, and we'd be in the same shape.
Really?
Yes, next week you can come.
That's not what I meant. Really? You're coming? You're doing this to me. My senior prom, and once again, you're making it all about you.
Excuse you, that is my job. As a mother.
All right, well, if you're going, I'm not.
Delaney, that's rude. She is your mother. You need to respect your elders.
Did you just call me elderly?
I'm literally trying to vouch for you, and you're correcting me.
Well, thank you, Josie. This elderly woman appreciates your kindness. $20 and you say it's a bad idea.
40. And you drive us to school for the next week.
Fine.
Mom, I think it's a bad idea.
Well, I have always liked your sister more. Anyways, Delaney, you're going.
That's fine.
You're forcing me to go to my senior prom.
Heck yes, I am. You obviously can't make decisions for yourself.
All right, you can go, and you can chaperone.
Really? Do you really mean that?
No, but you're not really giving me a choice.
Well, I'm gonna pretend that you just got super excited over me coming to prom and didn't make me feel like the world's worst mother.
You can come if.
If?
If you don't talk to me.
Fine. 3 interactions?
0.
2 it is. Get in the car, twins. Mama needs a new pants.
I am so sorry.
Who's excited to prom dress shop? Wah, wah! Do we have colors picked out? Dana, you're pale. I think blue matches craft for white. Thank you, Mrs. Lawrence. Joey, do you have a date? Any lady friends?
I still like boys, Mrs. Lawrence.
You can take to lady. Surprise you two. Best part, no touching will happen. Face to face, leave space. Big A.
This is why she can't come to prom.
I don't want
thinking I'm like her.
Who's Ricky? Is that a boy?
Oh, no, Frederica. You've met her before. She's nice and
a girl.
Definitely.
I hope I get to name this Frederica. She sounds wonderful. Anyway, I like your idea about matching data.
I never said that.
Shh. Soak in the compliment. I think I look best in blue, so do we all agree in blue? Perfect.
I don't think chaperones usually dress up for prom, considering they're not in high school.
I am not old school. All right, we're here. Who's ready to shop until we drop?
Drop dead? Who's ready to die?
Me.
No. No, we said that word too much today already.
You're not coming in.
Clearly? You do not know me very well.
Clearly, I do. And that's why I'm not letting you come in.
Fine. You know what? I'm not coming.
Good.
Have a grand old time without me. Have a blast. Being with me, Deborah Ann Morris, who spent 19 hours giving birth to you.
Love you.
Say no to strangers. Look both ways before crossing the street. I love you too.
All right. It's okay. I'll figure it out. I'll just stay here. Leave your mother to die in the bitter cold. I see how it is.
Prom, I didn't tell you. Funny story. Susan had an assistant to help run prom, and I threatened her with a bedazzler until she fired Mary and gave the position to me. But don't tell Delaney that. And now I'm helping run prom.
Oh my god, you didn't.
Oh my god, I did. And now I can make sure my baby isn't playing sausage wars with some gross boy at prom.
Debbie. I need you to apologize to Susan and let Delaney have some space. This is her senior prom.
What now?
Space.
I'll think about giving Delaney some space.
Thank you.
Okay, I thought about it and it's still a horrible idea. Why would you suggest that, Vernon?
Okay, I'm going upstairs to take a nap, and you are going to apologize to Susan. Goodbye!
Hi, Susan.
Hello, Deborah.
I was just wondering what colors you were wearing to prom. I love to coordinate. Coordination shows power.
A light red, perhaps the mellow version of burgundy.
Blue?
No, red.
Perfect, see you Friday.
Hello, fellow grade mothers, Pepsi members.
Pepsi? I thought you said Pepsi. I don't even have a kid here.
Participating citizens.
Hi, Susan!
Oh, Deborah, I didn't see you there.
Well, here I am, Deborah and Lawrence, ready to Pepsi this joint. What?
Actually, Pepsi is a noun, not a verb. No gold star for Deborah. Am I right, ladies? And Richard.
Do I need to get out of the dazzler?
Gold star for Deborah. Our first order of business is a very controversial one, so excuse me if I get choked up. Will we have a prom king and queen?
Hello, what other title is my daughter going to win? Students need to cry after prom. It's good for my Kleenex stocks. And this right here, is how you get them to cry.
This is what I'm worried about. Prom turning into some vulgar, barbaric competition where only the fittest become queen.
Just because your disaster of a daughter, Heather, isn't going to win, doesn't mean you get to punish the other students like my winner of a daughter, my sweet, sweet Delaney Bear.
Oh, we're having a prom queen, and Heather is going to kick Delaney's butt.
I'd say Delaney's gonna kick Hunter's butt too, but you have to have a butt to get it kicked.
Moving on, we need a theme. Any ideas? Yes, Mary.
Hi, excuse me, I'm Debbie, and I was raising my hand first, so I get to speak first. It's kind of an unspoken rule.
Oh, go ahead, Debbie.
Thank you, Mary. What if our theme this year is neon? We have a blackout decoration theme, and we wear the neon. We are the decorations.
Yikes. I don't know, sounds a little racy. Any other options? Was that, Mary?
Oh, nothing.
No, stand up for yourself, Mary. Voice your opinion. Stand up!
Okay. I think that we should think of some other ideas.
No, no. This is why you don't get to voice your opinion. Sit down.
Deborah, I'm going to speak for all of us in the room right now. I think it's best if you resign from the PAPSI. Therefore, I'm revoking your status as chaperone and assistant.
Classic Susan, always cracking a joke. Anyways, what's our next order of business?
I'm serious, Debbie.
No, you're Susan! Nobody? Let's not get too far ahead of ourselves. None of you care that I'm about to lose my lifelong dream of designing my daughter's senior prom? Mary, I stood up for you. It's your turn to pay me back. No?
I think it's best if you go, Debbie.
You know what? Fine. I quit. Ha! How about that, Susan?
Great.
Awesome.
Fantastic.
Are we still out for brunch next Tuesday?
Mm-hmm.
Fine. See you back.
Lawrence residence, Delaney speaking. Who is this?
It's me, Heather. How could you not recognize my voice?
Oh, hi, Heather. Why are you calling?
Just a heads up.
For what?
Just if you so much as breathe me a Ricky at prom, I'm going to have to shave your head and tell everyone you're pregnant with Joey's baby.
First off, chill. Second off, Joey's gay and my mother is a living, breathing abstinence ad. How is that ever going to work?
It's just a heads up.
Get bent, Heather. I'm going to pray towards whoever I want to pray towards a prom.
Hello, is this Delaney Lawrence?
Yes, hi. Who is speaking?
It's Ricky from chemistry.
Hi, Ricky. This is Delaney, who is in your chemistry class. But before you say anything, my mom, she's a wonderful lady. Really great. Actually, totally rocking was wondering if you were a boy or a girl?
I'm still a boy, Delaney. Anyways, you know how I skipped chemistry class today? I was wondering if you could give me the notes before class tomorrow?
Why were you skipping in a chemistry class? There are highly toxic chemicals that you could not... Oh, you mean like not showing up to school?
Yeah.
That's my fellow angsty teenager, Ricky. Am I right, bro?
Anyways...
Mom? Gotta go, Ricky! Bye, love you! Who's on the phone? Just Susan, just, you know, discussing the PAPC that I'm definitely still a part of.
Why would Susan call you about the PAPC? Heather told me today that her mom kicked you out.
No, I could... I mean, did I say Susan? I meant Mary. Mary from the PAPC.
Oh, the one you threatened Susan over. Rumor has it a bedazzler was involved. Why would she call you?
First off, I am just a bedazzled suburban mom. I don't threaten people with bedazzlers. I would never stoop that low. I'm just a casual mom of three that loves knitting, home-cooked meals, and long walks on the beach with family.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Well, then explain this.
Oh!
me. That is a different person.
Tell me, who was on the phone?
I'd love to tell you. It was... Would you look at the time? I gotta go to bed. Beauty rest isn't gonna get itself. Am I right? There's lasagna in the fridge. Don't do drugs. Good night. Abstinence is key. I love you.
Isn't Frederica just wonderful?
I can't believe you would do this to me.
Oh, who am I kidding? Such a Debbie thing to do.
Ta-da! Who's ready to get their freak on at prom? I hope they pick my favorite song, Like a Virgin by Madonna. Why, you ask? Because it promotes abstinence. Face to face, leave some space. Big A, big A, big A! Oh my God, Mom, what are you wearing? Look and learn, baby. Dana, I see you're not wearing blue. Yeah. Anywho, let's take pictures for your guys' senior prom.
I thought Susan said you couldn't chaperone for the prom, Mrs. Lawrence.
Well, hi to you too, Joey. Everyone's favorite gay supporting character. And well, Susan doesn't make all the rules at prom.
Isn't that what the head of the PAPC does?
Yes, they make the rules for most people. But I am not most people.
We know. You're... THE Deborah Ann Lawrence. Hello? Oh, okay. Debbie, honey, I'm sorry. I have to go into work, and it looks like you're gonna have to stay home and watch the twins.
Don't be silly! They can just come with us! Twins? Go get on some dress clothes. We can't have you two embarrassing mommy at the dance.
Well, this should be fun.
That's the spirit. I wonder if we'll run into our good pal, Frederica, at the dance tonight. Anyways, I'll meet you all in the car. I go front. Get it? Because I'm the driver, because I don't have to. Onward. Meet Mama Bear in the car, twins.
Can we please say a prayer for Aunt Delaney?
Okay. I think now would be an appropriate time.
Dear God, I don't know what Delaney did, but it must have been really bad for you to do this to her.
Hey.
Like, I don't know what happens behind closed doors, but Delaney doesn't seem to be a bad person. Anyway, I'm not promoting violence or anything, but if Mrs. L is to have a run-in with a bear and slip into a coma for a night, I don't think any of us would complain. And if it happened, I promise to go to church next week. Oh, also amen.
Amen.
Who is ready to party?
Hi, Mom.
Bye, Schmookums. Don't forget our two interactions.
This counts as one.
Oh, there's Punch over there and not enough space between us. Can't have you embarrassing mommy. Deborah? Susan? What are you doing here? I thought I told you your chaperoning privileges are revoked.
You did.
Then I suppose you'll be leaving. See, you'd be supposed to be wrong. Because 2 days ago, I ordered a mandatory parent meeting. They were shocked to learn that you threatened me with a bedazzler. They did say you do have the right to kick me off the PAPC, but I threatened to sue on her 19th Amendment, stating that it is my basic right as a mother and a woman. And look, I got my privileges reinstated. Isn't it funny how this all works out?
Fine, but you're walking a thin line tonight, Deborah. Remember, voting takes place at the ballot box by the punch. And boys and girls, 6 inches apart, minimally.
Oh, what about Joey?
Who's Joey?
Never mind. Watch out, you old bag. Excuse you, I may be old, but this bag is Prada.
Listen.
Hey, you're busted dance moves. out of here before I have my mother kicked in the path.
Shut your fat mouth! Or my dance moves aren't gonna be the only thing that's busted.
Fine.
Fine what?
Settle this.
Oh, bring it on.
Oh, this is not going to end well.
That explains a lot.
Oh. Round two? I can go.
I wish I would have known! I would have left!
Go in there, Taylor. Most of them are resting.
I love you too.
I love you so much, my baby bear.